Hello, we are looking at two virtual microscopy slides of the endometrium and myometrium side by side. On the left, we have normal proliferative endometrium, and on the right, we have an example of endometrial carcinoma. This is the commonest histologic type of endometrial carcinoma, which is known as endometrioid carcinoma. So we're going to do a comparison, and these two virtual slides are currently shown at the same magnification. If we directly compare the thickness of the endometrium, we can see that it is much thicker on the side of the endometrial carcinoma. And in fact, the junction between the endometrium and myometrium is very straight here on the left. But on the right side, we can see that there are these abnormal glands that are infiltrating into the superficial myometrium. So we have a thickened endometrium and we have some evidence of myometrial invasion of this carcinoma. Let's look at higher magnification. And again, these two views are at the same magnification. So on the left, we can see that the normal endometrial glands are very discrete and they are single glands, well formed, with a lot of stroma in between. Whereas in the side of the endometrial carcinoma, the glands are practically back to back. At higher magnification, we can see the glands are very complex. They are sharing walls, and also there is hardly any stroma in between. And when we see this kind of picture with no stroma, we call this back-to-back arrangement of glands. So we have much more complex glands, and they have this back-to-back arrangement with much less stroma than in the normal endometrium. Let's look at even higher magnification. And again, comparing these two pictures side by side, on the left we have normal proliferative phase endometrium. We can still see that most of the nuclei are polarized at the basal aspect of the columnar cells. And on the right, this endometrial carcinoma, the nuclei appear to be a little bit more stratified, occurring at all levels, right up to the luminal edge of the cell, and not just at the basal aspect. We can also see that the nuclei are larger on the right side, and I'm going to increase the magnification more. And we begin to see that some of the cells have prominent nucleoli, for example, here. And here we have two cells with prominent nucleoli. And on moving around, I can quite readily identify mitotic figures. For example, there is one here. And there are also some mitotic figures here, here, over here, and also over here, so they are quite readily identified. In terms of prognostic factors for endometrial carcinoma, one of the features is grading, and we can see that this tumor is still very gland forming. Almost everywhere we can still see glands, even though they are complex, but practically all of the tumor is gland forming. And if we look at the cytomorphology, the nuclei do appear to be certainly more pleomorphic than in the benign endometrium. However, we don't see very, very marked variation in nucleus size or pleomorphism. So this would be considered still a grade 1 endometrioid carcinoma. Sometimes squamous areas can also be seen in endometrioid carcinoma. However, this is not seen in this particular case. And if we look at another prognostic factor, which is staging, usually one of the local features of extent is how far into the myometrium this tumor invades. And we usually give a cutoff at half. So is it less than half or more than half? And this will affect the stage. And we can see here that this invades into less than half of the myometrium. Let's have a quick look at a gross picture. This is a virtual pathology specimen taken from our online virtual pathology museum in our web resource Pathweb. And this is a uterus that has been sectioned in the sagittal plane. We can see here that this is one of the stumps of the adnexal structures. And let's have a look again at the cut surface. And there is a very friable looking tumor, very irregular tumor, occupying almost the entire endometrial cavity. As we magnify the tumor, we can see that it appears at this point to arise from the endometrium. And this is the area of the myometrium. We don't see any very definite invasion grossly. However, we would have to examine this microscopically to really ascertain whether or not there is invasion. So, looking at this, we have a large friable tumor that is occupying and expanding almost the entire endometrial cavity. This particular tumor does not show obvious invasion into the myometrium in this plane of sectioning, and we also don't see it obviously invading into the cervix. What we can see is that it goes down into the lower uterine segment, but still within the uterine cavity. If you scroll down, you will also see some annotated microscopy descriptions as well as the talking pot video. If you would like full access to our online virtual pathology museum with more than 700 virtual specimens, you simply need to register for Pathweb. Registration is free and you can find the link in the video description. Hence, in summary, this is a virtual microscopy slide of endometrioid carcinoma, which is the commonest histologic type of endometrial carcinoma. This is associated with unopposed estrogen exposure and with a background of endometrial hyperplasia. We can see that this tumor is composed of complex glands, which are arranged in a back-to-back fashion with sharing of glandular walls and with relatively low degree of nuclear pleomorphism. And we can see also that this tumor is invading into the superficial aspect of the myometrium. Thank you.